Good morning, guys. Today is an awesome day because today we're going to Hobbiton. How's it going, guys? Today we are checking out my favorite activity to do in New Zealand. And yes, it is my favorite activity. I can confirm that because I have been here before. Now, before we start the tour, I'm going to give you some insight about Hobbiton. Peter Jackson and his crew went hunting for Hobbiton location to build for the films. He came across the Alexander's farm in which he talked to them about filming and building on his land. They agreed and they began construction. They built the first Hobbiton out of perishable materials. After filming, it was taken down and all that left was a facade. Through the passing time, people were visiting this location just to see where it was filmed, even if there was nothing left. Nearly 10 years later, when Peter Jackson came back to film the prequel trilogy, The Hobbit, the Alexanders and Peter Jackson discussed on building a permanent location. In a 2-year time, they built Hobbiton for the Hobbit films, and after filming there, they left it open for the public to enter. During this tour, I will be doing minimal talking because we do have a tour guide, and I know you guys want to see this place, not hear me rambling on, so please enjoy Hobbiton.
Garden, guys, we've got this fabulous looking fence. It's about 8 years old but was soaked in vinegar to create its aged appearance. When we were done with this, we added on what we like to call moss, which is this stuff here. It's a combination of wood chips, glue, lichen and paint. When we were finished with all of this, we added on a layer of natural yogurt. Now, I believe we came out here today to check out some hobbit holes, yes?
Mm-hmm.
Fantastic. It's pretty iconic. Who do you think lives there? It is Bilbo and Frodo Baggins' house, so it's super cool, right? Now, if you guys have watched The Hobbit, The Unexpected Journey, this is great because this is going to be our first little bit of scene recognition today. We have our Bilbo Baggins run down from the top of Bag End. He jumps over the gap in the hedge where that fence is. He comes running through this garden, down the pathway, and out through that cutting that we entered. As he does this, waving his little hobbit contract in the air, yelling, "I'm going on an adventure!" Yeah? Which is pretty cool. Now, not only does Bilbo run on his adventure out that way, but Gandalf and Frodo come in on the fireworks cart through there. Unfortunately, Frodo in real life is 5'6", and Gandalf in real life is 5'11". You know what happens when you stick those two next to each other? Not a lot, they look the same height. So what we did was we moved Frodo's seat 3 meters behind Gandalf's. This gave us a 4-foot hobbit and a 7-foot wizard. It is very cool. Now, we do have 44 of these gorgeous little hobbit holes out here today, so you're probably pretty interested as to how they're actually made, yeah? The way we made these hobbit holes is we dug out the dirt from the hillside, we put in a retaining wall which got bolted 5 meters back into the hillside. On top of that, we added up our beautiful front facade so everyone could look at a hobbit hole, then put on a roof and piled that roof with dirt, spraying on grass seed to give us the appearance of a hobbit hole built out of the hillside.
The hobbit holes do actually open, but there is absolutely nothing inside. All the filming was done off-site down in Wellington at the Weta Workshop Studios. You can still open some and check out the inside.
Welcome everyone to Bag End. This is our biggest hobbit hole out here. You can fit 30 people inside it. Now, the reason it was made so big is they needed to fit the film crew and film equipment in hopes of filming a beautiful sunset over those hills. Small problem, you know what doesn't happen out that way? Does not sit out that way. You know where it does sit? Yeah, behind Bag End. Awkward! But the pathways out here are super duper cool. The one that goes right up to Bilbo's doorway is one of the last remaining original features. One of the only things they didn't tear out and then replace for the Hobbit series. So what they did was left it just in there. Same as that little bench seat, that's where we see Bilbo and Gandalf blow these smoke rings together. Very cool, right? And if you look up from the pathway, you're going to see a little bit of paint inside the door, guys. Oh, you're all excited like we've just seen the inside of a hobbit hole.
When Gandalf first enters Bag End, he walks in, smacks his head on the chandelier, which is totally part of our script, by the way. Turns around a few moments later, smacks his head on a wooden beam. That was not part of our script. But apparently, real pain looked better than fake pain, so they kept it in the films, and voila, it's made it in there for everyone to check out today. This beautiful one just behind me here, this is the home of Samwise Gamgee at the end of the Lord of the Rings film. A young girl runs out from his hobbit hole to greet him as he walks up the pathway. Now that young girl is actually his daughter in real life, as well as our films. How cute, right? Gets even cuter when Rosie walks out. She walks out carrying a baby on her hip. The baby on her hip is her daughter in real life, as well as the films also. So it's a very cute scene, got lots of real family love. Now this beautiful yellow door behind me is 100% scale size, and what that means is if you are of hobbit height, you should be able to fit underneath the door without smacking your head. Now the other gorgeous thing about this one is that it's one of the ones with smoke.
Yeah, it's good.
How cool, right? Now you've also got our beautiful field just below it, and this is where Bilbo's 11th birthday occurs. How cool. Now that one took 3 nights of filming. Young children got bribed to come along with the promise of all the sugar they could consume. They rather liked that plan. Mm-hmm. Do you know who didn't like that plan?
The parents.
The parents were like, no. Mm-hmm. And then we said, hey parents, come on out as well. We'll give you all the beer you can drink for 3 nights in a row. And suddenly there was a bit of a change in tune and they came along as well. What they conveniently forgot to mention is that the beer they would be serving was 1% sobering thought beer. One that had specifically made for these films so people could be intact to act. There you go. Now they did have real food and a real party, but Bilbo's cake was not on the menu. That one they decided needed to last all 3 nights of filming, so they made it out of polystyrene instead. But there is a small issue with this. Polystyrene is incredibly flammable, so they wanted to make sure it had a real birthday cake flair and forgot about that fact. When Bilbo's birthday cake came out, they had placed 111 alight candles into it. Now you might remember that when Bilbo gives his birthday speech, there's a bit of an orange glow on his face. Ever wonder what that came from? If you did, I'm here to let you know it was his entire cake that was on fire beside him, giving him that beautiful orange glow.
Remember what Bilbo used to say? It's a dangerous business, Frodo.
Going out your door, you step onto the road, and if you don't keep your feet, there's no knowing where you might be swept off to.
Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope Hobbiton is just as special to you as it is to me. If you're in New Zealand, or specifically the North Island, Hobbiton is a must check out for anyone, even if you're not a Lord of the Rings or a Hobbit fan. As usual, till next time, I'll see you guys soon. I'll be holding you.